Are you wanting to combine a bunch of shorter videos into one long video? You can do that in Canva, but there are a few things to consider. If you need to learn how to use Canva for YouTube, then the Creator Classroom is the place for you. The first thing that you need to consider, do you want your videos to have a vertical format or a horizontal one? If you're making a video that's longer than 60 seconds, I really recommend using the horizontal format. The vertical format won't be put on a short shelf if it's longer than 60 seconds anyway. Let's get started by going to the Videos tab right here. What we're going to do is just select this one that says Video, which is a 1920 by 1080. You can even click this one that says YouTube video, like any of these are going to be fine. The first thing you need to know how to do in Canva is how to upload your own videos. You can do that by going over here. There's a left side panel right here. And this is some very basic information, but if you're brand new to Canva, you may not know how to do this. And my panel is going to look different than yours because every time I add something new, such as this is Brand Fetch where I can find brand logos, it pops up on my left-hand panel. If I don't want it there anymore, all I need to do is click X and it will clear things out. This is actually a folder of all of my March 2023 vertical videos and anything that has to do with March 2023 for my YouTube shorts. I'm going to leave it there because I'm still working on that. Up here at the tops, designs where you can choose video templates for your project. There's elements where you can choose things like photos, videos, lines, shapes, charts. What you need to know is the uploads folder. And the uploads folder is important because this is where you're going to upload all of your shorter clips into Canva so that you can put them back to back to back to make a longer compilation video. So we're going to click uploads. I wanted to see what these three little dots are. You can upload it from your computer. You can upload it from Google Drive, Dropbox, Facebook, Instagram, and look, there's something new, Google Photos. But I'm just going to take it straight from my computer, and I'm just going to pretend like these are the video clips that I want to put all together into one longer video. I can open them up all at one time and upload them all at one time. So I'm going to open them up and it's automatically going to go into my upload folder. Now, instead of uploading it into the uploads folder, you may want to create a brand new folder for your project. Let's call this compilation and continue. So now I've got this brand new folder and I could at this point, I could technically add those files into that one folder. That way it's already organized for me. And this is a fantastic use of folders. That way your uploads tab doesn't get as bogged down as mine does. So I know this is a lot of basic information, but if you're brand new to Canva, these are things that you do not know yet. There's like a progress bar here at the bottom. Hopefully while I'm editing, I have stretched this out so that you can see that there is a progress bar and things are moving right along. Probably should have put them in the vertical video format, but that's okay. And I've put it on page one. What we're gonna do here is just set it down here at the bottom and size it so that it is 1080 tall. We're going to position it in the center so that it's right there. If you're doing this sort of YouTube shorts into a regular size horizontal landscape video, do something in the background so that it's not just white. What if we just do like dark texture? This isn't something that you would need to do if you were doing a regular landscape video into a landscape video project, but I just wanted to show you some of the things that you need to consider if you're doing a compilation from YouTube Shorts to regular landscape size, so that if you have your short right there, then there's something on either side. And as we go on, I'll show you some more things to consider as well. So what we're going to do is just click add a page, and I'm going to choose another video. We're going to size it so that it is the right size, and we're going to position it. It is in the center in the middle. Another thing that you could do back here would be pop up some calls to action during your video. You want to subscribe animation like this, and you want it to be on one side of your video. Bonus tip, if you right click, you can show timing, and it will show you that that animation is going to show across that entire clip. If you want it shorter than the clip that you are compiling, then you can just simply reduce the size of it. Now let's go ahead and add a page. If you've done something like I have here, where I've got just me on the background or on the bottom, and it may not look good, but would be to remove the bit on top. And then it will take over the background. This isn't my favorite because it might not be that clear, but it is an option. The other thing that you might do would be to put it on one side, add some captioning. I could do that and just put that right there. I might even could add a simple text writer effect on enter. And something you may want to consider when you are combining a bunch of different smaller videos is make sure you leave space on each end, and you could add a transition in Canva. And you would do that by hovering between the two pages, and you can click this bottom button, add a transition. And what it will do is transition from one video to another right there. So that's exactly what that did. And this is a new animation called Flow. And these transitions are a free feature in Canva. And you can even change how long or short it takes. And you will notice that there are some purple lines right here in between the two pages. And those lines are actually how long the transition is. How much of the audio might be clipped? That's your keyword. That's why you want a little space at the end. And if I made this longer, that purple spot would be bigger. So you can visually see what's between the two video segments. We're going to see if I can play it. I don't know if you could hear that, but the audio of one started playing over the other. So you really need to be careful and aware of what the end of one video sounds like and looks like, and what the end of the next video clip sounds like. The other thing you can just do is simply set video as background, but then you might need to left click and move it. If you are doing videos that are longer, then you may not have enough space on Canva to upload those videos, especially if you're using the free version of Canva. Let me show you what I mean. I'm going to click down here on the question mark, and I'm going to type in upload. Here it is. Upload formats and requirements. Free users can only upload 5 gig of media. So that's one limitation you have. If you have Canva Pro, you can upload up to 100 gig of stuff. That means you probably won't have to worry for a while about the sheer number of items that you're uploading into Canva. So when I was using the free account, I used to have to delete things all the time. You still have limits in the size of things that you can upload. So like if I go down to video right here, they take MOV files, GIF, MP4, MPEG, MKV, WebM. However, it has to be less than 1 gig in size. If it's more than one gig, it won't be accepted. Here's another advantage to Canva Pro. Canva free users will be asked to compress the file if it's between, well, if it's over 250 meg. So in between 250 meg and 1 gig, if you are using Canva free, they will ask you to compress that file. Here's where the pitch comes in. If you want to try Canva Pro free for 30 days, then take a look in the description. I'm going to leave a link for you that will give you that free trial. Back to the lesson. It also tells you what video formats won't work. They will not take videos with a transparent background. You can always upload a video with a background, and then if you have Canva Pro, you can remove that background with the image. And I will show you what I mean, except for this one won't work well, but there is, if you click a video, there's a background remover feature that Canva Pro has. So that's just another added benefit. You need to click on the X down here at the bottom in order to get rid of that. This isn't all of the files, but I just wanted to show you how to, I say quickly, but we've been doing this for a while, but it's because I'm showing you a bunch of different things. Put whatever you want to in them and whatever, and downloading's easy. Share, download. You could make sure you have all your pages selected. Make sure you have the quality that you want. If you, for some reason, have 4K video and you have Canva Pro, then make sure you bump that up to the 4K size. We don't need that because these are 1080 video. All right, so then you would just click download. Something always pops up when you're downloading. Always. Sometimes it's something like this. Want others to watch this? Send this to someone so they can watch it. It will also show you your progress. Now, how can you get rid of this? Simple. All you need to do is click out of it and it will go away. Your progress bar is still down there at the bottom, and you can click it and check in to see how it's doing. Now, again, because this is internet based, it takes a while for some of these processes to complete. It is 34 seconds long, and as you see, I've been talking through that, and it is still downloading. If you love learning how to use Canva for YouTube, then what you're going to want to do is check into this playlist that's on your screen right now, because I'm going to put a playlist there that talks about different ways to use Canva for YouTube. All right, I'll see you next time. Bye.